Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school, and she kissed her head and said I was just like you. You're gonna miss this, you're gonna want this back, you're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You're gonna miss this. Before she knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place. She says it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies and buying a house. Daddy shakes his head and says, baby, just slow down. 'Cause you're gonna miss this, you're gonna want this back, you're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. Mistakes. 5 years later, there's a plumber working on the water heater. Dogs barking, phones ringing, one kid's crying, one kid's screaming, and she keeps apologizing. He says they don't bother me, I've got two babies of my own, one's 36, one's 23. Hard to believe, but you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this.
Welcome to the first ever Eastmark High School graduation ceremony. Please rise for the processional performed by our Eastmark High School band and orchestra under the direction of Mr. Jacob Campos and Mr. Volker Molding, and remain standing for the presentation and posting of colors by the Queen Creek High School Junior ROTC and the national anthem performed by the Eastmark Coppertones, directed by Mrs. Cynthia Catchpole. Thank you. You may be seated. My name is Paul Gignon, and I'm the proud principal of Eastmark High School. It takes a village to raise a child, and we are so appreciative of this village. Graduates, please join me in a round of applause for your parents, friends, family, teachers, and other supporters who have helped you get here today. Now I'd like to welcome to the microphone Dr. Perry Berry, our superintendent of schools.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, members of the faculty, school board, community members, and graduating seniors. This is graduation week throughout our country. In big cities like Phoenix and small communities alike, people come together to pay tribute to their beloved senior student. Commencement ceremonies always bring special emotions, but this particular event means a lot more simply because this event marks the very first graduating class from Eastmark High School. And before I do my job and introduce my colleagues, which is my job, I want to take a quick moment and go down memory lane and reflect on a few memories that make tonight's event extraordinary. And to provide some context, the vision of this school, Eastmark High School, was set 7 years ago. I was a brand new superintendent. We had barely built a GPA just down the road in about 5 months. These graduating seniors here tonight were in sixth grade, and this area up in the Southeast Mesa was one of the top 10 areas per capita in the country. Our governing board superintendent team at the time was committed to serving the families of this part of the district, but we had a couple of problems. No money, no land, and a brand new superintendent didn't know how to navigate this process and working with the state. So looking back, I remember many long days, countless trips to downtown Phoenix, a lot of adversity, arguments, and a lot of prayers. And we had a vision, and we needed to serve the families in this community with the high school, and it was a challenge, to say the least. So after many sleepless nights, looking at every option, we finally successfully applied for the funding through the state, which is called the Schools Facility Board, to purchase the land. And then soon thereafter, we also, with community support, passed a bond in 2017. And we put those two pots of money together, coupled that money together, and we were able to build the phase one of Eastmark High School. And this is the very school that you will call your alma mater. 6 years ago, I remember driving through this dirt road out here. This was a big open lot full of cement, rubble, a lot of debris. And now it stands as a state-of-the-art facility that prepares our young people for the lives that you're going to lead outside of school. So looking back, I was a first-year superintendent. We were actually the first district in Arizona in almost 12 years to successfully apply for and land new construction money in the state of Arizona. And why do I bring this up? Because being the first of anything can be a challenge. It requires leadership, requires bravery, confidence, and a little bit of luck. And when I look at this graduating class, I see just that. I see the first graduates of this school, but I also see students who outperform statewide standards, who took their teams to the next level, students who innovated through science and technology, and who carried us through artistic endeavors. But most of all, I see students who rose to the challenges the world has never seen and overcame them with strength and resilience. These accomplishments are made possible through the support, the collective support of many people, starting with family members, teachers, faculty, governing board members, administrators, district leaders in the community. And I want to take a moment to pause and thank some of the people who make Queen Creek Schools the premier place for education, starting with our five elected governing board members, starting with President Ken Bragg, not in attendance, Vice President Jennifer Rebolt, Board Member Samantha Davis, Board Member Matt Riffey, and Board Member Patty Campbell. These people are elected citizens who volunteer their time to serve our students, staff, and community. Our district, as you probably know, is the fastest growing district in Arizona and perhaps the whole region. Our board is dedicated to doing what is right in the best interest of our students, and we have faced tremendous growth challenges, and there probably are more ahead, but I appreciate this board because they always do what's right for our students. And I want to have you take a moment to watch this quick video message from our board members to our senior graduates.
Senior class of 2022, congratulations on graduating. You have been given a foundation to build the rest of your life upon. Be confident, be kind, be nice, and serve others. Critics will tell you, beware of the storm. You are firebirds, you are the storm. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2022. I am so proud of all of the hard work that you've put in to get to this point. Now it's time to go out, spread your wings, and figure out exactly who you were meant to be. My advice to you is to dream big, put in the hard work, give back, and never settle. I wish you all the very best. Congratulations.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2022. Remember to be bold enough to use your voice, brave enough to listen to your heart, and strong enough to live the life you've always imagined. We are so proud of each and every one of you. Now go live your journey. Congratulations, Firebirds.
Congratulations, seniors. This is a very exciting time. You should all be very proud of your accomplishment. This is the first of many things you will accomplish in life. And as you embark on this journey we call adulthood, I want to challenge you all to greet the future with anticipation, set big goals, and never give up on your dreams. Congratulations. Go Firebirds.
Hello, class of 2022. Congratulations. I hope each of you takes a moment to reflect on the great accomplishment that you've had this year. As you go forward in your endeavors, remember to try hard in everything you do and treat people as you would like to be treated. Go Firebirds!
Next, I would like to introduce and recognize the cabinet-level administrators. These are the people that I work closest with that support all of the departments and all of the school sites. Among many things, these people ensure that we are in compliance and make decisions to ensure our district has adequate resources to have our students excel. And I'd like to thank the Queen Creek cabinet members for the support they provide our students, starting with Chief Operating Officer Dr. Matt Strom, who's up in the crowd tonight. Assistant Superintendent of Elementary Instruction, Erica Copeland. Assistant Superintendent of Secondary Schools, Dr. Chris Thuman. Chief Financial Officer, Amber Stewart. And Director of HR, Human Resources, Dr. Patty Rogers. Last but not least, I want to take a moment and thank the site administration and the entire faculty at Eastmark High School who educated, inspired, motivated, and encouraged our students to reach their full potential. Please recognize the Eastmark High School administrators that are in attendance and on the stage with me. Principal Paul Gagnon, and assistant principals Crystal Keller, Jesse Roth, Craig Luschner, and Dean of Students Renee Woodward. Thank you to the entire Eastmark High School staff. Tonight's celebration obviously would not be possible without you. Thank you for what you do. And in closing, I just want to once again congratulate the class of 2022. Challenge you tonight or this week or sometime soon, pause and take a moment to thank the people who have helped you along the way. God bless you all. And at this point, I'd like to introduce the senior class president, Adeline Longhorst.
Hello, my name is Adeline Longhorst, and I am the senior class president of the class of 2022. We've been told for the past 3 years that we are the first graduating class of Eastmark High School. Let us not forget our first that led us to the one we're at now. Our first steps, our first words, our first laughs. The first time some of you picked up a bat, or kicked a soccer ball, or turned on a microphone. Let us not forget our first silly bands, our first pair of Heelys. They shape who we are and they give us experience. Through our firsts, Eastmark gained experience. The 130 graduates sitting in those seats get to claim Eastmark's firsts. However, we are so much more than the first graduating class. We're the first student council members, team captains, club presidents, Mr. Firebird, AP students, prom royalty, Firebird feed anchors, and graduates. There isn't an accurate way to describe the difficulty of filling those positions for the first time. Although we have been praised about being the first graduating class, encouraged to start traditions and get involved and seek out potential, we were given essentially no funds to kickstart these programs into existence. Do you know how difficult it is to start an entire drama program with no money? Ask the chiropractors of the audience who would sit on the learning stairs on our school's first ever Broadway musical, The Music Man. Ask our Winter Guard team exactly how much work it took to be Eastmark's first ever state champions. First ever state championship team. Ask the senior class genuinely how good it feels to win the Spirit Stick without cheating, may I add. Shout out to Party City. Try to understand that blood, sweat, and tears went into the foundations of these programs, all knowing full well that we won't even be able to see the fruits of our labor. We worked this whole year on building traditions, improving school spirit, leading chants, just to leave. That takes a certain type of student, a certain type of leader. The type of students that can recognize that the foundation isn't the prettiest part of the building, but it is the most important. The type of student that can be satisfied and happy, sitting in their seats right there, happy with what they did with their time, happy with the foundation that they built, and that is all they need. Martin Luther King Jr. said in his letters from Birmingham Jail, "It is the strangely irrational notion that there is something in the very flow of time that will inevitably cure all ills. Actually, time is neutral. It can either be used destructively or constructively. How did you use your last 4 years of high school, your last 3 or 2 or 1 year at Eastmark High School? Was it constructive? Was it destructive? We put on Eastmark's first ever prom in the courtyard and we used tablecloths as decorations. We built the first push-up board and we watched the sun rise and set as a senior class. We took the first W as a senior class in Powder Puff. Hi, juniors. And we won the Spirit Stake 100% of the available times this past semester, which was twice. We organized and we executed a successful senior skip day, which was kind of funny. And we were all up by 6:30 this morning for practice graduation. That was constructive. Now, I want you graduates to recall something. Do you guys remember in March when the juniors took the ACT and we had our first 2.5 hour long A hour? The staff called us down to the cafeteria for a senior meeting and we all sat there waiting to be addressed. Do you remember when Mr. Gagnon handed the microphone to Mr. Ammon? Do you remember what he said? How he said he felt about us? Some of you might not remember, but he was honest with us and he told us what we needed to do for the rest of the year. Did you change his mind? Did we as a whole change his mind? Did you use your time constructively or destructively? We have a lifetime of firsts ahead of us. The first time we move out, the first college class, the first time that we realize we're broke college kids. Eastmark will stay here and it'll grow its lists of seconds and thirds and 50ths, but we have firsts ahead of us. Think about it. We have the first athletic signees, academic scholars, called elders. We'll make it far. Will you use your time constructively? I need to take a moment of time that could never be enough for the people who got me here. My parents and family gave me the support that I needed to get through high school. My friends kept me grounded and helped me through breathing exercises when I was stressed. I want to thank Ms. Catchpole for being the most patient and hardworking teacher that I've ever had. I would like to thank Sydney Lawson. Also, happy 3 months. I would like to thank my board for working hard all year. I would like to thank Esther Robinson for being the perfect vice president and the perfect counterpartner for me. Finally, I need to thank the senior board advisor, Mr. Ammon, who worked tirelessly this year for the senior class and who truly found ways to say yes, who built the foundation as the first graduating class as a senior at his high school and who brought that knowledge and applied it here at our school. We could not have done it without you. In Gwen Stacy's valedictorian speech from The Amazing Spider-Man 2, she says, "The future is and should be bright, but like our brief 4 years in high school, what makes life valuable is that it doesn't last forever. What makes it valuable is that it ends." She continues to say, "Fight for what matters to you, no matter what. Because even if you fall short, what better way is there to live?" We have been told for the past 3 years that we are the first graduating class from Eastmark High School. What else will you be a part of? What other foundations will you build? What will you fight for? Don't forget where you came from and where your childhood ended. Don't forget how every shade of teal and copper in this building is different. Don't forget the rolling chairs and the walk to the seminary building. We have things to remember, and I encourage you to look back at them with gratitude. We have things to be proud of. Be proud of them. Enjoy the rest of your first, graduates. Thank you. Please join me in welcoming my fellow Firebird, Caden Foley.
Good evening, fellow students, parents, teachers, and staff. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Caden Foley. For those of you who are looking at me right now and thinking that I'm Joey Wilcoxon, I'm not. I'm just his best friend that looks like him. Thank you so much for coming to our Eastmark Class of 2022 graduation. It's amazing to see all of you here, and I'm so excited to finally be here. It's been such a long and arduous journey, and I could not be more ecstatic that we finally made it here. Tonight, I have some topics that I really hold close to my heart that I would like to share with all of you. The first thing that I'd like to talk about is the unorthodox nature of our high school experience. Everyone had to go through COVID, and we're all very aware of the consequences that came from that and how it affected our high school experience. So, as weird an experience as that was, that's not what I'm talking about right now. I'm talking about how we are the first graduating class that this high school has ever seen. Can we get a quick round of applause for our seniors here? So, we have been tasked with something that is extremely difficult to do, to build the culture of a brand new school. We have no stories from past classes to look back on. We never had older grades to look up to. We didn't come into the school with established sports programs and a case full of trophies. We had to create those things for ourselves. Now, we all have our own unique stories and experiences. We've become the role models for younger grades that we never had, and we've built our sports in the ground up with some playoff entries and a couple state champions. We've built our own unique culture, and although it is by no means perfect yet, I think that that's something to be proud of. The next thing that I'd like to talk about, and I promise Mr. Gagnon did not make me say this, is respect. I think something a lot of us may not realize is just how important respect is for our own success. I know this sounds like cliche motivational speaker preaching, but I really do believe this from the bottom of my heart. The best way to get what you want from someone in life is to show them respect. This doesn't mean to be their puppy dog and bend to their will. You just need to show people that you care. There is not a single teacher here that expected every student to get an A, or even wanted that at all. They just wanted us to try. They just wanted to know that we care. If you do your work to the best of your ability, and you listen to them when they're talking, and you show them that you care about their class, even if you don't, then they will give you the respect that you deserve. The point of school is not necessarily to learn math and science and language. Maybe that's how it started, but that's not all that it is now. It's meant to teach us how to act in an environment where our attitude and behavior matters, to teach us how to show respect. If you get a job in the future, which we will have to, and you don't listen to your employer or show them respect, there will be no mercy. You just lose your job. Now, it's no secret that respect is inherently important and a valuable moral, and it's very important in the aspect of kindness and making people feel valued, but you already know that. Right now, I'm trying to tell you that this is important if you want to succeed in life. To relate it to school, if we showed our teacher respect the entire year, they were more likely to help us out. Assignment extensions, rounding grades, stuff like that. Likewise, our employers will be more likely to give us more responsibilities, be more susceptible to raises, and show us respect if we give it to them. And most importantly, you should understand the respect that you deserve. If you do everything you can to show someone respect and they will not give it back, maybe it's time to consider a change of scenery. As a person, you are inherently valuable. You deserve respect just as much as you should give it. If someone can't show you the respect you deserve, then they do not deserve you. In summation, respect serves two very important functions. On one hand, it's an important key to success in the future. It's how you earn the favor of anyone you may encounter in a future career. On the other hand, it's the best way to show someone that you value them. And value is something that everyone should get to feel. Another thing that I would like to address tonight is gratitude. As a class, we have, from time to time, been known to complain about things that we think we deserve rather than being appreciative for what we do have. I'm not saying all of the complaints are invalid, as I have been very guilty of this as well, but just that it's also important for us to consider what we have been given by the school. A lot of times in life, you may do everything in your ability to get what you want, and you still won't get it, and that's okay. You're not going to win every battle. We're very lucky to have gone to the school that we went to. We have far nicer facilities and opportunities than a lot of other schools have. I think we have been given more than we realize, and that's something that we need to be aware of. To all the teachers, staff, and parents that made these years possible, just know that the majority of us are grateful for what you've done for us. Often it seems the voices that complain are the loudest. However, at the moment, I have this microphone and these big speakers, so I am actually the loudest. So I would like to say to all the teachers who dealt with this class every day, who taught us important lessons, whether they were about the subject they were teaching or something else entirely, who gave us every opportunity to succeed, and who truly cared about us, thank you. To the security guards and the custodians for looking after us, talking to us, and making us feel both welcome and safe. There was not a single day this year in which I left the school and Mr. Green wasn't there to say goodbye and tell me to have a good day. Thank you. And to the administration who worked behind the scenes and allowed this school to function and worked to the best of their ability to make high school the best possible experience for us, thank you. And last, to the parents, to my parents, thank you for supporting me no matter what, for taking care of me, for being there for me no matter the circumstances, for loving me unconditionally. Thank you. The last thing I'd like to talk about tonight is drive. We are nowhere near the end. Right now, regardless of how we feel about our high school performance, there's nothing that we can do to change it. It's over, but that's okay. A couple months back, I was talking to my trainer, Preston, who's a very, very smart man, and I was shocked to learn that he was not exactly a star student in high school. He barely made the cut for graduation. In college, however, he decided to work a little harder, put a bit more work into it. He graduated with 3.5. Later on, in his master's program, he really hit his stride, and he graduated with a 4.0. Our high school performance does not dictate how successful our lives will be. It's not too late to find our drives. It's important to learn how to cope with disappointment in a healthy way and move past it. That's something I've struggled with a lot these past couple years, and it's something that I still struggle with. In 10th grade, I was taking a certain AP class that I thought was hard, so naturally, being the 15-year-old that I was, I thought I was hot stuff. As I came to find out, I was not hot stuff. I got a 2 on the AP test. For those of you unfamiliar with the AP grading system, that's a failing grade. That really took me by surprise, and it did not feel good, but there was nothing that I could do to change that, so I pushed forward. Some of you may already know this one, but I applied to Stanford this year, and I really did think that I could get in for whatever reason. But life doesn't always go the way that you want. I spent months curating what I thought to be the best essays I'd ever written, but I still didn't get in, and it hurt really bad. I was feeling down for a good amount of time, but my dad told me that this is by no means the end. He said that if it really is my dream to go there, that I could get there one day. But even still, I don't need a school to prove to myself what I already know. I can find another path to success. So I picked myself up, and I kept pushing through the rest of this year. For those of you that came to my volleyball games this year, you may have found yourself wondering why I invited you to watch my friends kick butt while I sat on the bench. In my defense, my team is still pretty cool to watch, even without me up there. As for me, however, I found volleyball to be a very humbling activity. However, even though I wasn't anywhere near the best, and at times I wanted to quit, I learned to become part of the team. I went to every practice and every game, I cheered as loud as I could, and I played my heart out when I did eventually go in for games. That was my contribution. From there, I started to realize that the team wasn't just about volleyball and how good we were at it. It was about the brotherhood, the dancing, the jokes, the music, the bus rides, In-N-Out, Dutch, Star Wars night, Goodwill runs. It was about each other. If I got caught up in the game and focused on my failures, I never would have realized that. When I started volleyball, I wanted to quit so bad. And now, it's the hardest thing that I have to leave behind. My point in all of this is that no obstacle or setback will ever be enough to take you down if you refuse to let it. It's never too late to pick ourselves up and find our drive. Regardless of our present standings in life, any given person on this field right now could end up becoming the most successful out of us all. It's never too late. You can't change your past. You can only work to improve your future. I'll end with this. A lot of people get caught up in high school. They have the best 4 years of their life, and then just like that, it's gone. They think they can never rise higher. They peak. Don't let that be you. Take hold of your future, create your own path, find your drive, and never stop pushing forward. Thank you. Thanks. Next, we will have a few words from our principal, Mr. Gagnon.
Caden, by the way, you're supposed to say our fearless leader, Mr. Gagnon. Stick to the script, buddy. Just kidding. As high school principal, I'm honored to address this group of seniors, the first ever in the history of this school. Receiving their diplomas tonight indicates that they have satisfactorily completed the course of study prescribed for them by the state of Arizona and by the Queen Creek Unified School District Governing Board. Graduation is a celebration of your achievements over the last 12 years, an opportunity to think about how far you have come from the time you entered school and what you can accomplish in the future. As the famous writer Charles Dickens wrote in A Tale of Two Cities, your time at Eastmark has probably been the best of times and the worst of times. For some of you tonight, it is a reprieve from what you've considered to be a journey through Dante's Inferno, while for others, you made the most of coming to a new school, making new friends, and starting to build a culture. We've gone through so much together in these 3 years, a fire in the bathroom the very first month of school, state playoff games, being around junior high students, and starting traditions like senior sunrise, senior sunset, and baccalaureate. As you walk across the stage to symbolically leave the comfort of our nest and spread your wings in the real world, I want you to consider the story of the chef's daughter. Once there was a girl who was complaining to her dad that her life was so hard and that she didn't know how she would get through all of her struggles. She was tired. She felt like as soon as one of her problems was solved, another would arise. I could definitely relate to that for a while, not saying anything to his daughter. After 20 minutes, he removed the potatoes from the pot, put them in a bowl. He did the same with the boiled eggs. He then used a ladle to scoop the coffee into a mug. He asked his daughter, "What do you see?" She responded, "Potatoes, eggs, and coffee." Her father told her to take a closer look, touch the potatoes. After doing so, she noticed they were soft. Her father then told her to break open an egg. She acknowledged the hard-boiled egg. Finally, he told her to take a sip of the coffee. It was rich and delicious. After asking her father what all of this meant, he explained that each of the three food items had just undergone the same exact hardship, 20 minutes in boiling water. However, each item had a different reaction. The potato went into the water as a strong, hard item, but after being boiled, it turned soft and weak. The egg was fragile when it entered into the water, with a thin outer shell protecting a liquid interior. However, after it boiled, the inside of the egg became firm and strong. Finally, the ground coffee beans were different. Upon being exposed to boiling water, they changed the water to create something new altogether. He then asked his daughter, "Which are you? When you face adversity, do you respond by becoming soft and weak? Do you build strength? Or do you change the situation?" All right, so what's the point? Life is full of ups and downs, wins and losses, big shifts. Adversity is a big part of this experience we call life. Many of us, me included, have experienced a lot of adversity over the last 3 years. However, you choose how you react to it. Do you let it break you down, or do you bow up to it? Do you step back and take away the lesson adversity is teaching you, or do you run from it? So I ask, class of 22, are you the potato, the egg, or the coffee bean? Class of 22, you put us on the map, literally. We have much to be proud of, including two region athletic championships, a state championship band program, and as a class, you were offered $3.6 million in scholarship money. You set a strong course for future EHS graduating classes to follow. You have much to be proud of, and know that we are proud of you and celebrate your accomplishments tonight as any proud parent would celebrate their son or daughter's accomplishments. With this said, I am very honored this evening to present to everyone the Eastmark High School graduating class of 2022. Congratulations. Now let us welcome to the stage Governing Board President Ken Brigg, who will give the Governing Board's acceptance speech.
Let's tighten this bad boy up. Nope. All right, I'm just gonna hold it. Okay. Sometimes when you're in a dark place, you think you've been buried, but actually you've been planted. You are the inaugural class of Eastmark High. Congratulations. Because you're the first, I want to give you guys a choice. I've prepared two different speeches. You guys can have the positive speech, or you can have the pessimistic speech. So by raise of hands, who wants the positive? Okay, who wants the negative? All right, looks like a tie, I'll do both. All right. So, first of all, those sons, man, that was embarrassing. What else? Today's my birthday, and I'm stuck here doing this. Ugh. Congratulations on doing the bare minimum required by law to get out of school. You had to suffer through the growing pains of a brand new campus. Not only that, you had to put up with this disruptive policies keeping you out of the classroom for a good chunk of your high school career. Normal extracurricular activities were stripped from you because of the flu. Your class is too small to have a normal experience. I'm sorry you can't stay in high school because it looks really rough out there after high school. College debt is overwhelming. Inflation is out of control. Cars and real estate have never been more expensive. How will you guys ever move anywhere? Americans hate each other. People are mean. Global warming is going to ruin everything for everyone. What's the point? Oh my gosh, did you guys see the Suns? They broke their franchise record for regular season wins. They are awesome. Today's my birthday, and I get to celebrate it with hundreds, if not thousands, people. This is awesome. Congratulations on doing a great job. You have persevered and worked hard and have earned your high school diploma. You got to be in a brand new state-of-the-art learning institution. You've had the freedom and privilege of learning in and out of the classroom. You've got to experience new creative ways to have activities and to socialize. You were so lucky to be in such an intimate setting where you could really get to know most of your classmates. The future has never been brighter. We are making technical advances by leaps and bounds. Every company I can think of is trying to hire people. We have never been more diverse and more inclusive in the history of this country. Experts are saying that in 20 years, a third of all the jobs don't yet exist. The world is your oyster. With all of this technology and everything we've experienced from working remotely, I can work from just about anywhere. Everything that I've said tonight is absolutely true. Whatever you are looking for, you're gonna find it. If you want to see everything as rosy, you will never run out of great things to appreciate. Likewise, if you want to look at life as a victim and that everyone is against you, you will never run out of things to support that theory. Great things are going to happen in your life. Really horrible things are going to happen in your life. Life is amazing, and guess what? Life sucks. Where are you going to place yourself? You need to decide where you want to be. Are you buried or are you planted? On February 9th, 1990, my life changed forever. That was the day that I got set up on a blind date with the most beautiful girl I had ever known. She was stunning. She was a smoke show. She was, by all standards, way out of my league. She had a boyfriend, but he was a jerk. And long story short, we got married 2 years later. She gave me 5 incredibly smart and beautiful kids. She's not only an amazing mom, but she's a brilliant businesswoman. She's a volunteer with youth. She's a chair on the board of adjustments in the town. And she's an incredible granny for our 2 grandkids. Throughout our marriage, people ask me, how did you get her? And my answer's always been the same. She had horrible vision, so she couldn't really see me. And she needed hearing aids, so she couldn't really hear me. Her loss was my gain. And so for you football fans, another way of saying this is I totally outkicked my coverage. 7 months ago, on the night of homecoming, she had a pulmonary embolism, and she went home for good. After fighting to stabilize her for hours, the doctor turned to me and said, you know, we believe she's brain dead. We believe we've broken every bone in her chest trying to resuscitate her. It's our recommendation that you do not resuscitate. And so I had to choose in front of my kids to let that happen. Are you buried or are you planted? It is very hard to feel planted when you feel completely buried. It is very hard to tell your kids that they have been planted when you see them being buried. I want you all to know that I'm absolutely devastated by the loss of my incredible wife. I'm devastated for my kids as well. They will not have their mom to help them with their weddings. They will not have their mom spoiling their children. They will not have their mom telling them that everything is going to be okay and it's going to work out. But guess what? My kids have been planted. We will not let our lives fall apart because she's not with us physically. We'll be sad for her not being here, but we are so grateful that she launched us on our current trajectory. I'm so grateful for the amazing 32 years that I got to be by her side. Do not let horrible things change who you are for the worse. I'm so thankful for the pain and the tears that I feel and shed for my wife. It lets me know how much love I have and how much I miss her. It's a constant reminder of how lucky I was for 32 years. It helps me relate to others who have experienced great loss. You can do hard things. One of the things that I try to live by, and I'm going to challenge you to try to live up to, is the lyrics of one of my favorite songs, The Impossible Dream. To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to fight though your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know, if I only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart may lay peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man, scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to fight the unbeatable foe and to reach the unreachable star. Always make sure you're planted and not buried. Congratulations, Firebirds. And please welcome Mrs. Shelley Swisher and Mr. Drew Ammon to the stage to announce our graduates.
Amelia Barton.
Caden Foley.
Becca Hinton.
Adeline Longhurst.
Victoria Lyon.
Esther Grace Robinson.
Xavier Strom.
Jenna Swearstra.
Lily Thorid.
Yazid J. Elnajar.
Kyson Alvin.
Natea Sky Marie Atkinson.
Tyler Bailey.
Brianna Baker.
Kyler Baker.
Samantha Barrientos.
Arthur Bauer.
Caitlin Joy Baumgartner.
Jaden Bergant.
Melody Boucher.
Kristen Taylor Brinkman.
Cameron Brown.
Susan Callahan.
Adam Kaye.
Lydia Carter.
Angelica Castaneda.
Evan Check.
Cruz Cervantes.
Kylie Chandler.
Andrew Christensen.
Shelby Grace Claridge.
Marquez Clark Holmes.
Joyce Bethany Covarrubias.
Nick Collins.
Landon Cologne.
Madison Conover.
Jeffrey Cummins.
Jaden Davis.
Gavin Deechy.
Joseph Doherty.
Jasmine Dondero.
Rachel Esparza.
Logan Eaton.
Kyla Floyd.
Kenyon Evans.
Haley Foote.
Grace Foote.
Suzanne Marie Harunjo.
Jordan Galvin.
Jenna Halcom.
Nartel Gladney.
Andrew Harris.
Laura Grant.
Julius Hirschfield.
Charlotte Lynn Hamilton.
Emma Huang.
Riley Hatch.
Jasmine Jackson.
Christopher William Hauser.
Michael Jones.
Alexandria Lynn Irvine.
Jameson Keeler.
Carlos Angelo Jacobs.
Devontae Laughing.
Taylor Jones.
James Leck.
Taylor LaFond.
Lovey Leon.
Sydney Lawson.
Savannah Lucas.
Jordan Lee.
Derek Martin.
Mr. Firebird, Michael Lines.
Sophia Martinez.
Ryan Michael.
Ethan Merlos, E Money.
Alyssa Manzo.
Brendan Mitchell.
Caden Martinez.
Talon Mark Monet.
Brooklyn Renee Moore.
Ethan Morey.
Brennan Meyer.
Rachel Knave.
Brianna Mitchell.
Josiah Ohm.
Anaya Angelica Nicole Millage.
Andrew Paulo.
Reagan Newby.
Tatum Perrine.
Mia Pelton.
Alexis Peterson.
Tabitha Peterson.
Zachary David Phillips.
Travell Peterson.
Matthew Ramsdale.
Andrew Braden Puzder.
Matthew Reyes.
Colin Randolph.
Adam Richards.
Morgan Rice.
Peyton Ryan.
Caesar Ruiz.
Addison Schmitz.
Jesse James Chantel.
Justin Chulzy.
Ethan Schoolcraft.
Ethan Showers.
Sam Self.
Alexandra Sneed.
Ryan Schramm.
Eben Stanley.
Emma Sowards.
Trinity Stewart.
Emilia Steele.
Elizabeth Terry.
Miley Ray Stones.
Alexia Totonis.
Tristan Judge Thomas.
Alec Vaez.
Sophia Totonis.
David Nathaniel Walker.
Bella Venata.
Rayleigh Wells.
Paul Walsh.
Fabian Wigman.
Kyle Wheaton.
Lane Wiley.
Joey Wilcoxon.
Aiden Wright.
Maya Williams. Yanis Young.
All right, one more huge round of applause for our graduates. Great job, guys. Next up, we'd like to welcome Rebecca Hinton to the stage.
That was the longest walk of my life. This is a little scary, and I thought it would. Believe it or not, I don't love public speaking, which is surprising because I don't shut up in most of my classes. But with that said, I understand that I'm one of the last things standing between you and leaving, so I'll hurry it up. Some of us had no clue what we were doing 6 months ago. Some of us had no clue 6 minutes ago, and some of us still may not know. However, we've got time. So I've asked some of the teachers and staff we've been privileged to spend our last 3 years with to give their final bits of advice to the class of 2022. Ms. Swisher said, "I wish I had realized how quickly time would pass by. I spent a lot of my time wishing away instead of enjoying everyday moments and making as many memories as I could. Life goes by so quickly, and I wasted a lot of time not enjoying every moment. These last 3 years have flashed by, and I never thought they would. I always thought people were lying when they said that I blinked my eyes and it was gone." What's interesting is that Mr. Ammon had something very similar to say to Ms. Swisher. He said, "I wish someone would have told me to live in the now. Life is happening right now. We will never get this moment or time back. So take a second, like Mr. Ammon said, and take this moment in. Enjoy our gorgeous caps and gowns. Listen and look at the people around you." He finished up by saying, "I would tell your class not to be afraid of being different. We are always comparing ourselves to others, but in reality, what we think of ourselves and what level we aspire to be is the most important. Do not be afraid to take the road less traveled or do the uncommon." Mr. Roth wishes someone would have grabbed him by the collar and said, "Listen, life during your college years will be so much harder than you can imagine, so much harder than your high school years. Prepare yourself for some of life's greatest hardships, financial, heartbreak, overscheduling, stretch to the max emotionally and physically. But it will all work out in the end. You will need to keep going and remember it will all be okay." He also gave the following advice to all of us, saying, "The class of 2022, as you head out into the world, the most important thing you can ever do, above career success, above partying, above fun times, is to be kind and helpful to others. It is the most important thing that you can do in your whole lifetime." I think he hit that right on the head. And while these lessons are amazing, and I'm sure they'll help every single one of us, there are some of us, including myself, that are stubborn enough that we will have to learn our own lessons through trial and error. So to all the mothers and fathers, guardians, or whoever signs those stupid syllabuses at the beginning of each year, thank you for allowing us to fail. We will all fail. It's inevitable, but it's not the end, because failure is actually just the beginning. President Obama said the real test is not whether you avoid failure, because you won't. It's whether you let it harden or shame you into inaction, or whether you learn from it, whether you choose to persevere. Failure will teach us so much more than success ever will. It will teach us more about ourselves, about our families, our friends, our dedication, and determination. Failure is necessary to grow. J. J.K. Rowling's quote actually inspired me to try to speak at graduation, and I think it's applicable for all of us going forward. She said, "It's impossible to live without failing at something unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all, in which case you fail by default." That's what J.K. Rowling said. "Personally, I have lived so much of my life scared of being embarrassed or scared of failing. I've dropped out of elections, given up my spot for sports teams. I've made excuse after excuse to ensure I didn't fail. But I realized that I wasn't succeeding either. I was stuck in the bubble I like to call perfectionism. But after years and years of struggling, I realized that whenever I failed, nothing happened. I realized that the fear of failure was preventing me from growing and living to my fullest potential. What's the worst that can happen? If you ever find yourself scared to fail, try doing it on purpose. I'm not saying fail your final exam or burn down your kitchen while trying to cook breakfast, but find ways to fail so you feel comfortable to eventually grow. You will never know how far you can go if you just stand in the same spot your whole life. However, sometimes failure isn't a choice that happens due to our choices. Sometimes it happens due to more serious issues. 73% of students will experience some sort of mental health crisis during college. With that statistic, it's a roadblock that many, if not all of us, will or have faced in our next stage of growth. This will look different for everybody because it's personal. But if you listen to one thing tonight, please listen to this. Just because we're adults doesn't mean we have to do it alone. It does not mean we have to go through life alone. Failure, growth, and learning isn't a solo journey. Look around. Every single one of these people here today love you. You are worth it. Don't be afraid to seek out help. We are worth it. In your times of deepest despair, please do not forget that. I'd like to take a moment to express my gratitude for all those who helped me throughout my life. I am forever thankful for my friends and family. Happy birthday, Grandpa. I'd like to thank my mom and dad for supporting and encouraging me. I'd like to thank my brothers, Nathan and Jared, for being some of the best examples I've ever had. I'd like to thank my little brothers and sisters, I know, there's a lot of us, for bringing joy and some much-needed humility into my life. I'd like to thank Andrew Surfland, the creator of Quizlet, the best studying platform there is, and Andrew Paulo, who made me consider speaking during the graduation ceremony in the first place. And to be honest, my whole econ class. I've never met a group of people so smart, but so not smart at the same time. Except for Lily, she's a genius all the time. Shout out to all my friends for all the good times. They were what I truly needed in high school. I think that we should also thank ourselves. We put in the hard work. We wouldn't be here without us. We have dedicated our last 3 years with creating and building a culture that will have to withstand the effects of time. We have had to nurture our athletic programs, sports teams, clubs, school spirit, and each other. As we worked to build, we had to put time into our grades, as well as extracurriculars to ensure a good foundation for the future Firebirds. We've done a good job. We should be proud of ourselves. I would like to thank all of those here today for lending your support and love to your children. It has made a difference in our lives. Having attended 6 different schools to date, I am so grateful for every single one of my teachers. Teachers, you were entrusted to raise and teach the rising generation, and I can say with confidence that most of us are ready and mature enough for the real world. I am thankful for the teachers that stepped up, that went the extra mile, that taught the hard but necessary lessons, that dedicated hours after school to help plan prom or let us tailgate in the back of their car before football games. You will never be forgotten. I am thankful for being able to graduate with the class of 2022 at Eastmark. Now we get a look to our future. You've got to know when it's time to turn the page, and today, my Firebirds, is the day that we have to turn the page. And that's the scary part about graduation, because once we leave the stadium today, our identity will not be an Eastmark High School student anymore. We will have to find fulfillment in something else. It's up to us to determine what we want our future and our legacy to look like. Let me be the first to tell you that I believe you can do it. Whatever that is, whether it's starting a business, being the first in your family to graduate college, to get a doctorate degree, to be a pilot, a mother, a father, a lawyer, I believe each one of you can do great things. But the final piece is for you individually to believe that you can do it, to stop holding yourself back. Someone once said, "Don't fear the unknown, embrace the opportunity." Eastmark, failure is not permanent. You may not know what life will hold. You may not know your very next move. You may not know your next steps. But I encourage you not to let that hold you back, because the fear of the future is always overcome by the joy in the journey. Here's to our future journey, and here's to our class of 2022. Congratulations, graduates. And now I'd like to introduce the one and only Esther Robinson.
Hello. Students, please rise and remain standing for the Eastmark High School alma mater performed for the very first time by the Eastmark High School Choir and Orchestra. That was gorgeous. All right. The turning of the tassel is a tradition used to signify a person's transition from candidate to graduate, a symbol of success. Graduates, please join me now as we move our tassels from the right to the left. Firebirds, classmates, friends, we made it. So, for the last time ever, class dismissed.
Yeah.